Hi guys, welcome back. And in today's Q1 FY25 result update, we'll be talking about three companies, and all the three companies have done blockbuster set of numbers, really over exceeded the guidance that is given by them. You know, like I always tell, under promise and over deliver. And you know, like kuch complain karne ka layak hi nahi choda. That's what it is. So the three companies we'll be discussing is Tinna Rubber and Infrastructure, Zomato, and PNGS Garg. Somehow when I make a video, only the dogs in my street needs to bark. Somebody needs to be going, you know, in the road. I just don't understand. Like while I'm sitting and taking down notes, it's absolutely shant. And right now everybody and everything seems to be making noise. So please put up with that. Okay. So the first company we'll be doing is Tinna Rubber and Infrastructure. Okay. By the way, all the companies ka business analysis, that is it. That is, if you want to understand the model in depth, I've covered all of it in my YouTube channel. Like you can just go to the business analysis playlist. You'll find it over there. Okay, right now I'll just give you a brief, you know, in a very sweet and short way. Okay, so Tinna Rubber and Infrastructure, if you see, what they do is aapka jo tire hota hai, right, the tires that can no longer be used, that is what we call as end of life cycle tires. Okay, isko they recycle it, you know, they take these tires, they add, crush it, and they add some, you know, products or, you know, other kind of components, and they make it into a reusable product, you know, which can be used further into manufacturing it. So agar aap unka segment jo dekhte, char segment hai, revenue ka segment. Okay, so the first one, if you look at it, the first one is called as your infrastructure segment. So in infrastructure segment, what they do, this end of life cycle tire, that is there, it is mixed with a component called bitumen, and it is used in making of your roads. Okay, and this contributes around 45% of their revenue. Okay, the second thing that is there, the second one is your industrial segment. Industrial segment mein, you know, these tires that are there, it goes on to, you know, again they make it, add some component, they make it even stiffer, and you know, it goes on to make new tires. Or aapka jo conveyor belts jo hota hai, right, you would have seen this PIX industry use it. Makes conveyor belts. So aapka jo belt hota hai, ek machine mein aisa aisa ghumta hai na, that is called as conveyor belt. Usme jata hai. And this segment, aapka industrial segment jo hai, it contributes 28% of the revenue. Theek hai. Then ek steel abrasion ka balls banta hai isse, which contributes 18%. And the last one is aapka consumer segment. This consumer segment is the fastest growing segment for them, and it contributes 8%. Consumer segment ka mein kya banta hai? Aapka jo tire se, isse recycle karke, it is used in making gym ka mat. Aap dekh sakte ho, if you are going to a gym, you would see this black color ka ek mat hota hai aapka, you know, it is laid down on the floor, so the tiles doesn't get affected if let's say the heavy weights are dropped. Those aapka jo balls hota hai, all of these different kind of, you know, consumer segment pe unka dalta hai. Theek hai, so this is roughly their business model. Theek hai, one interesting thing about this company is, in I still remember October 22nd, the investor PPT came out for Q2 of FY23. This is FY24, right? Yeah, FY23-24 ka. In that, they had given this vision, okay? Vision 2027. So in that vision, what they told, going forward, they are targeting a revenue of 900 crores. That time, the revenue was 300 crores. So they want to triple their revenue. They want to go, they want to be like a 25% ka CAGR revenue. Like, you know, the top line will grow at that rate. The bottom line, they're targeting around, profitability will be around 33% CAGR. Unka jo plant ka location hai, they have 6 plants, and they would want to, you know, increase it to 10 plants. And the most important thing, in tires, right, whatever the tires they get, they have to crush it, right? And this tire crushing capacity, they wanted to 4x it, okay? That time it was 85,000 metric tons, I think, per annum. And they wanted to target up to 2.5 lakhs metric tons per annum. So this was a vision, this was a guidance that was given to them, given to the investors for FY2027, okay? And they have been doing exactly that, you know, going in that manner only. And for this year, they have a target of achieving 500 crores in revenue, okay? 500 crores in revenue for the full year. And the management had told ki like roughly you can expect a run rate of 110 crores every quarter. You know, that is like a benchmark for us. Okay, comes the Q1 FY25 numbers, and Q1 FY25 numbers have been absolutely stunning, right? Like I told you, the expectation was around 110 crores of revenue, but they have done 136 crores in revenue, 34 to 36 crores in revenue they've done. So if you look at the sales that is there, sales has grown by 70% on a year-on-year basis. Agar aap QOQ bhi dekhte ho, QOQ also has grown by 23%. PAT jo hai, PAT has literally doubled, right? 132% on a year on year basis, aur unka jo QOQ hai, QOQ mein it has gone increased by 4.4. Aapka jo PAT margin hai, PAT margin also has gone from 8.7 to 10%. So all the parameters that you see, whether it is sales, PAT margin, aapka dekho, EPS dekho, EBITDA margin dekho, everything has improved. Okay, just one thing if you see, EBITDA margin as of right now, Q1 FY25 is 16.8%. And they have a target to reach 18%, you know, by FY27. This quarter, a lot of improvement, little bit margins has been affected because inka jo raw material jo hai, they import maximum of it, okay? And as you all know, right, like Red Sea ka crisis hai, you know, because of that, the freight cost has gone up. And because of these things, you know, little bit operating margin has not really improved a lot. This is one reason. And the other reason is, you will see that the employee cost has gone up because there is this one time employee ko bonus dena padta and everything, that is there. And the last thing is, they have taken some capex, right? Some operational capex they are doing in one of their plants. As a result, you will see operating margin has not improved a lot. But keeping that aside, all the parameters, like I told you, tick tick tick, like I told you, right, 110 crores Karnataka, but they did 136 crores, that too in Q1. Let me remind you, Q1 we are seeing across industries, we are seeing that, you know, there has been slowdown, right, because of elections and heat waves. But for them it has been a boon, because elections ke kya time kya hota hai, because of elections, you know, the government has to really prove itself. Kya hota hai, roads sub, you know, ज्यादा रोड्स बनते हैं. एंड लाइक इनका 45% का रेवेन्यू आता है कहाँ से, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर से. इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में ये लोग क्या बनाते हैं, रोड्स बनाते हैं. सो दैट इज व्हाई यू विल सी दिस टाइम दे हैव एक्चुअली ओवरडन इन दिस क्वार्टर. सो गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स. मैं इसका वॉल्यूम ग्रोथ के बारे में बताती हूँ. वॉल्यूम ग्रोथ इन टर्म्स ऑल्सो, वॉल्यूम ग्रोथ इनका जो है 25% ऑन क्यूओक्यू बेसिस, दैट इज Q4 ऑन Q1. एंड लास्ट Q1 से इस Q1 में यू विल सी दैट 75%, ठीक है. एंड द टायर क्रशिंग कैपेसिटी जो मैंने बोला था, दे हैव अ टारगेट ऑफ अचीविंग टायर क्रशिंग कैपेसिटी of 2.5 lakhs metric tons in FY27, and this year they're expected to do 1,50,000. Q1 mein unhone kiya tha 38,500 metric tons. So the volume growth has been increased by 22%, and on a year on year basis 70%. And tire crushing capacity also has increased, okay. Tire crushing capacity also has increased from 22,000 metric tons to 38,500 metric tons. Very beautiful. Even if you multiply na 38,500 into 4, like aram se, like beautifully, they will be able to do more than that 1.5 lakhs unka target is. So just great. I will just go lastly, I'll cover the two things, unka jo future ka kya capex plan hai, abhi ka kya capex plan hai is saal ke liye, and volume, like segment wise we will understand ke liye kya ho raha hai. Like I told you, unka jo infrastructure ka segment hai, right, infrastructure ka segment contributes 45% to the revenue. Yahan pe volume growth has been very stunning, 65% ka volume growth tha. Like I told you, Q1 mein zyada roads hue because of the election season, iske wajah se. And they also secured 15,000 tons of new order, ठीक है. अगर आप industrial में भी देखते हो, industrial also had a volume growth of 6%, and this segment contributes 28% of the revenue, ठीक है. Steel में भी अच्छा सा volume growth था, steel abrasion में भी 72%, और consumer segment में it is 150%. And one of the reason consumer segment grew at 150%, मतलब volume growth हुआ, first of all इसका base बहुत छोटा है, like I told you ना, सिर्फ 8% ये contribute करते हैं revenue के लिए. So one of the reasons why it grew by 150% also, उनका last time Feb 2024 में वार्ले का प्लांट दैट वॉज इट दैट गॉट कमीशन, दैट गॉट ऑपरेशनल, एंड दिस द कैपेसिटी हैड बीन इंक्रीज्ड, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अभी ये कमीशन हुआ, इट इज वर्किंग इन द फुल स्विंग, इसके वजह से यू नो दे आर एबल टू डू दैट. सो लाइक यू कैन सी, सारा सेगमेंट जो है इज बीन डूइंग वेल, सारे में सारे बहुत अच्छा वॉल्यूम ग्रोथ है, ठीक है. अगर इस साल का बात करें, इस साल में अगर आप देखते हो केपेक्स जो है FY25 में, इट इज जस्ट 40 to 50 crores ऑफ केपेक्स. ज्यादा से ज्यादा कुछ केपेक्स नहीं करे, सिर्फ एक ऑपरेशनल केपेक्स जो है, आप मेंटेनेंस केपेक्स जो बोलते हो वही हो रहा है. उनका जो एक प्लांट है वाडा प्लांट देर, वहां पे वो लोग सोलार का इंस्टॉलेशन लगा रहे. एंड आई थिंक आउट ऑफ दिस 40-50 crores दैट दे हैव सैंक्शन, 28 crores हैज ऑलरेडी बीन पुट टू यूज. वन इज फॉर दिस वाडा प्लांट, देर इंस्टॉलिंग दिस सोलार कैपेसिटी विच विल बी कमीशन बाय Q2, ठीक है. और उनका जो वार्ले का एक प्लांट है, वार्ले का प्लांट में यू नो देर डूइंग सम बिल्डिंग एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का, लाइक आई टोल्ड यू मेंटेनेंस केपेक्स है. एंड क्रम कैपेसिटी जो है देर प्लानिंग टू इंक्रीज इट, ओके. दिस विल बी कमीशन बाय Q3. एंड द लास्ट इज चेन्नई में एक प्लांट है. चेन्नई में क्या हो रहा है, वो पावर लोडिंग दे वांट टू इंक्रीज ओवर देयर. एंड उनका जो माइक्रोनाइज्ड रबर प्रोडक्ट विच इज MRP, विच इज वन ऑफ देयर बेस्ट प्रोडक्ट दैट इज देयर, दिस आल्सो दे वांट टू बिट यू नो एड ऑन टू द कैपेसिटी. सो ये सब जो है Q2 और Q3 बाय मैक्स बाय दैट ऑल ऑफ दिस मेंटेनेंस केपेक्स विल बी डन, ठीक है. दिस इज द केपेक्स फॉर FY25. अगर आप आगे जाके देखोगे FY20 लाइक द नेक्स्ट ईयर एंड ऑल, लाइक आई टोल्ड यू ना इन देयर गाइडेंस फॉर विजन फॉर 2027, व्हाट डिड दे टेल, दे विल गो फ्रॉम 6 प्लांट्स टू 10 प्लांट्स, एंड दैट इज एग्जैक्टली what they're doing right now. Unka jo Oman ka plant, okay, they have one international plant, Oman mein, which they acquired last year. Here, what they're doing, they're trying to get a permission for a new land from the government of Oman, you know, to set up a new tire recycling plant, okay. That is there. And this should be done by Q3 of this year, okay. Other than that, they have started a new subsidiary in Saudi Arabia called Tinna Rubber Arabia LLC. So they've started this. And you know, the reason is to set up a plant in Saudi Arabia and to start the tire recycling process over there, okay. Other than that, if you see, iska jo hai, capacity is around 25,000 tons per annum, and the capex will be costing 20 crore for them. The last one is in South Africa, they're in talks for a joint venture with a local company again to set up a tire manufacturing plant, a tire recycling plant over there. They cannot manufacturing, recycling. So three plants they want to do. One again in Oman they already have. They want to start a new thing, Saudi Arabia and South Africa. So from six again they can go to eight plants easily from here. Should be done, I think, probably by this year. No timeline on the Saudi and the South Africa ka joint venture kaisa hoga. But all in all, good set of numbers. Like I told you, like tino company jo hum aaj discuss karne wale, like कुछ भी कंप्लेन करने का लायक ही नहीं छोड़ा है. मतलब एवरीथिंग हैज बीन सीमलेस एग्जीक्यूशन, एब्सोल्युटली सीमलेस. गाइडेंस हैज ऑलवेज बीन ओवरडन, यू नो, जस्ट ब्यूटिफुल. लाइक देर इज नो वर्ड्स, यू नो, व्हेन यू ईट सम रियली गुड डिश एंड यू हैव नथिंग टू कंप्लेन, इट जस्ट hits all your taste buds and you just can't do this, stop doing this action and give a chef's kiss. That's how the result of like literally this Tinna Rubber has been this time, ठीक है. The next company we'll do is Zomato. And Zomato again, brilliant set of numbers. If you see, let's just go over Zomato ka business model once. If you look at Zomato, Zomato has many verticals, okay. They have B2C vertical as well as B2B verticals. Unka B2C verticals agar aap dekhte ho direct consumer ke liye, ek hota hai unka food delivery app, theek hai. The second jo hota hai is aapka Blinkit ka, theek hai, wo quick commerce jo hai, theek hai. The last one in the B2C segment is Going Out, Zomato Going Out. Zomato Going Out is, आपने तो देखा ही होगा ना, ये Zomaland करके एक event होता है once in a year in metropolitan cities where a lot of restaurants come together and put up stalls. So Zomaland हो गया, या you know, you book this reservations in your Zomato app, you know, you pay some things, that also comes under Going Out. Or whether when you're going to dine out in a restaurant and you pay via the Zomato app, this also is considered among the Going Out. आपका जो भी लाइव जो भी होता है जोमैटो में, आप टिकट्स बुक करते हो एंड एवरीथिंग, ऑल ऑफ दिस कम्स अंडर गोइंग आउट बिजनेस, ठीक है. सो थ्री सेगमेंट्स दैट आर देयर इन द B2C स्पेस, फूड डिलीवरी, क्विक कॉमर्स एंड जोमैटो गोइंग आउट, ओके. द लास्ट वन इन द B2B सेगमेंट, दे हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज हाइपर प्योर. हाइपर प्योर का इट इज बेसिकली द सेम फूड डिलीवरी ऐप जैसा करते हैं, लाइक दैट ओनली, बट आपको होटल के लिए. लेट्स से द होटल्स नीड रॉ मटेरियल्स एंड एवरीथिंग ना फॉर देयर ऑपरेशंस, सो जोमैटो डज दिस फॉर देम. इट्स अ B2B ऑपरेशंस ओवर हियर. सो दिस इज बेसिकली व्हाट Zomato does, ठीक है. Now if you look at the sales has been very stunning. Like आप अगर year on year देखते हो, year on year has grown by 71%, and अगर आप QOQ देखते हो, QOQ has grown by 17%, ठीक है. PAT जो है, PAT has grown. Last time का PAT था 2 crore Q1 of last year, and इस Q1 में PAT है 250 crore. So you will see huge growth in PAT also. और अगर आप पैट अगर आप QOQ देखते हो, QOQ पैट हैज ग्रोन बाय 44%, ठीक है. सो गुड अमाउंट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग लेवरेज इज विटनेस्ड इन द बिजनेस. ऑफ कोर्स अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल थिंक दैट बेस इज गेटिंग बिगर तो थोड़ा जाके प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी कम होगा, बट दैट हैज नॉट बीन द केस. क्योंकि लास्ट Q4 में अगर आप देखते हो, Q4 में उनका पैट था अराउंड 170-179 crores, और अभी इसमें Q1 में अगर आप देखते हो, Q1 में इज अराउंड 250 crores. सो रफली 40% से तो पैट हैज बीन इंक्रीज, राइट. सो इट्स एक्चुअली अ गुड शो ऑफ डील. पैट मार्जिन अभी है 5.6. सो ऑन ऑल पैरामीटर्स अगेन द सेम थिंग, वेरी वेरी गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स, ठीक है. अगर आप इसका रेवेन्यू ब्रेक डाउन करते हो, उनका जो फूड डिलीवरी ऐप है ना, आपका Zomato में जब आप रेस्टोरेंट से ऑर्डर करते हो, दिस कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट 46% टू द रेवेन्यू, ठीक है. और उनका जो हाइपर प्योर है, लाइक आई टोल्ड यू, जो B2B सेगमेंट है, जो होटल के लिए करता है, दैट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट 28%. एंड उनका जो क्विक कॉमर्स इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग 22% टू द रेवेन्यू. एंड गोइंग आउट बिजनेस है हार्डली 2.2% टू द रेवेन्यू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट. सो दिस इज अ रेवेन्यू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन. और इसका अगर आप देखते हो GOV, दैट इज अ ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू. नाउ ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू का मतलब क्या है, लेट्स से आप, आई जस्ट गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल, ठीक है. लेट्स से व्हेन यू आर ऑर्डरिंग फ्रॉम Zomato, राइट, देर इज वन, दैट इज योर टोटल, आपका जो है आपका फूड का प्राइसेस है, विच इज वन वे ऑफ सेल्स. बट देर आर मेनी इफ यू गो लुक एट दैट आपका जो बिल है देर आर यू विल सी देर आर मेनी थिंग्स राइट. वन इज आपका जो आइटम जो खरीदा, लेट्स आपने डोसा खरीदा, डोसा का एक प्राइस है. देन आफ्टर दैट प्लेटफॉर्म फीस है. देन आफ्टर दैट आपका डिलीवरी चार्ज है राइट. एंड लेट्स से देर इज सम डिस्काउंट एंड एवरीथिंग. दिस ग्रॉस आर द ऑर्डर वैल्यूज टोटल थिंग्स. एक बिल में जो कुछ भी आइटम्स आते हैं दैट इज योर आइटम, द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ द आइटम दैट यू परचेस्ड प्लस द प्लेटफॉर्म फीस प्लस आपका डिलीवरी चार्जेस माइनस द डिस्काउंट्स और वॉट एवर एग्जिस्ट ओवर देयर. ठीक है, ऑल ऑफ दिस इन टोटल जो हम बोलते हैं इसको हम बोलते हैं ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू. और सारा का सारा बिजनेस जो है सब का सब यू विल सी ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू दैट इज देयर हैज इंक्रीज्ड राइट. एंड इंक्रीज्ड एट अ ह्यूज रेट बोथ ऑन अ ईयर ऑन ईयर एज वेल एज ऑन अ क्यूओक्यू बेसिस. ठीक है, एंड ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर सच एप्स ओवर ईयर. अगर आप देखते हो फूड डिलीवरी का जो ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू है, आप बोल सकते हो ये एक इन अ वे यू कैन टेल ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू इज लाइक वैल्यू ग्रोथ आप देखते हो एक बिजनेस में. ठीक है, आई थिंक इट्स वैल्यू ओनली आप बोल सकते हो राइट, या वॉल्यूम. आई डोंट नो हाउ यू कंसीडर वेदर इट इज वॉल्यूम और वैल्यू ग्रोथ. ठीक है, सो नाउ इफ यू लुक एट द ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू फॉर जोमैटो, आपका फूड डिलीवरी बिजनेस जो है इट हैज ग्रोन बाय 27% ऑन ईयर बेसिस. नॉट अ स्मॉल नंबर, डबल डिजिट है इसका. ठीक है, और क्वार्टर ऑन क्वार्टर जो है इट हैज ग्रोन बाय 10% ऑन क्यूओक्यू बेसिस. ठीक है, बिकॉज ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू थिंग्स राइट. मतलब जितना आपका ऑर्डर बढ़ेगा उतना आपका ग्रॉस ऑर्डर वैल्यू ज्यादा ही होता रहेगा. दैट इज वन वॉल्यूम. The other thing why it can also be a value thing is because आपका platform fees आता है यहाँ पे. So the more increase you take in platform fees, even that affects your gross order value, right? So it is a combination of both volume plus value metric over here. Okay? So you will see that 27% and 10% year on year and QOV. अगर आप उसका quick commerce में देखते हो, quick commerce also has grown by 130% on a year on year GOV and 22% on a QOQ basis. ठीक है, और उनका जो going out जो business है वो भी has grown by 106% on a year on year basis and 19% on a QOQ. ये सारा नंबर जो है ये GOV है एंड एब्सोल्युटली स्टनिंग लाइक आई टोल्ड यू. ठीक है, अगर हम इसका बोलते हैं GOV, हम बोलते हैं इस फूड डिलीवरी का, दे हैव टोल्ड लाइक इन द लास्ट 5 years राइट, FY20 to FY24 4 years आप पकड़ लो, द GOV फॉर द फूड डिलीवरी ऐप हैज ग्रोन बाय 30% ओके, ऑन अ रफली 30% CAGR. एंड आई डू नॉट सी वाई एनी रीजन इट कांट ग्रो एट दिस रेट गोइंग फॉरवर्ड, बिकॉज यू नो एटलीस्ट फॉर द नेक्स्ट फाइव ईयर्स, बिकॉज यू नो लाइक आई टोल्ड यू द हैबिट्स ऑफ पीपल आर चेंजिंग. ठीक है, अभी हम इन डेप्थ में जाते हैं इन टर्म्स ऑफ उनका जो बेस्ट बिजनेस है जो है क्विक कॉमर्स, बिकॉज ब्लिंकिट, द अक्वायरिंग ऑफ ब्लिंकिट हैज लिटरली बीन अ गेम चेंजर फॉर जोमैटो. ठीक है, पहला इन द लास्ट कॉन कॉल दिस पीपल टोल्ड उनके पास एज ऑफ Q4 ऑफ लास्ट ईयर ईयर एंड में दे हैड अराउंड 530 स्टोर्स था. ठीक है, एंड दे टोल्ड इस साल में इन द कमिंग ईयर दे विल डबल दिस ब्लिंकिट का स्टोर्स, डार्क स्टोर्स हम बोलते हैं ना, दे वॉन्टेड टू टेक इट अप फ्रॉम 500 to 1,000. दैट वॉज वन थिंग. ठीक है, द सेकेंड थिंग was like I actually didn't know this, you know, like last time when I read the comm call I was really amazed ki like Blinkit jo hai it is quite operational, you know, in 8 metropolitan cities only, and Delhi mein jo hai it is only in the Delhi NCR region it is penetrated a lot. Okay, and the top other cities that are there, whether it is Bangalore, Hyderabad and Bombay, it has not reached the GOV level of Delhi, you know, that is what it is. So you know, they had a very rapid store expansion plan, you know, and right now if you see they've overdone it also, because they had a roughly target of opening 100 dark stores every quarter. This quarter they opened 113, and not only that, they are on track to achieve that 1000 stores by this year, dark stores. They are telling ki like ye 1000 se hum 2000 karenge in FY26, because see, one thing over here is speed is very important, but thoda sa margins effect hoga, but we will not compromise on profitability. So really I really like that. The other thing is उनका GOV, like I told you, if you look last year में 353 stores था उनका, like I think 350 stores का GOV अगर आप देखते हो, it was around 6 lakhs. इस साल में when they had, I think when they closed it around, they had 639 stores in this quarter, and the GOV has crossed 10 lakhs per store. Amazing. And the top 50 stores है, उनका gross order value is around 18 lakhs. Like brilliant set of numbers, like I just can't even fathom, okay? And the reason why Blinkit is seeing such kind of growth, like unimaginable kind of growth, is because there are three reasons. One is RAA consumption growth. From that angle the growth is coming, because let's say for example you are in a rush and you want to buy some kind of toiletries and other things, right? Look, boom, you might not find it in the local store, you'll go to Blinkit. Or let's say you're in an office and you want to buy a big treat for your colleagues and everything, right? All of a sudden what do you do? Blinkit. So the market share they're capturing is not from a kirana stores or the likes of DMart or anything. It is coming from this consumption based, where the other stores are not not able to cater. Okay, and I think the founder of Blinkit, that is here, Albinder, was telling like, how can they compete with Kirana stores? Kirana store, you know, they have this bookkeeping system now, where you buy everything and pay at the end of the month. We don't do that, unfortunately, right? So that is what it is. So this entire thing is coming from consumption. The second thing, the reason they're able to do it is from retailers, bada retailers. Like, for example, Nature's Basket, I think, is one example, you know, where if you go to a store like Nature's Basket, or, you know, I think, which is the other one? It is there in, you know, in that Phoenix Mall, ka jo baju mein hai in Bangalore. I think Food World is the name, you're right? So if you go to these kind of stores, you get a plethora of options. It's like under one roof, you get everything. You want a normal pasta, gluten-free pasta, you want this artisanal cheese. Like literally, you know, this big store where you get an assortment of things. These people are targeting that, you know, you get that at the comfort of your home. And it is true, right? Like, I know I'm in Bangalore and I need some Thai curry paste and all. I have to go to Nature's Basket in Kormangla, right? I don't get it. But right now, I just go to Swiggy, Instamart or Blinkit. So that is one thing. So targeting big retailers. And the last thing is, you know, from next day delivery. Jo aap Amazon se karte ho, let's say you want an AirPods or anything. Jo aapko like ek din ke baad milta hai. Now if you go to Quick Commerce, you just get it in like instantly 8 to 15 minutes, right? So these are the three verticals from which they're able to grab market shares. You know, this is the concept for them, right? So this is where the entire Blinkit ka game is changing. And the last thing is in the B2C segment, what they're doing is like unka sara ka sara B2C segment mein you can see growth. Like I told you, food delivery system mein, they're targeting a 30% ka CAGR going forward in the next 5 years. Unka Blinkit mein, like I told you, they will double the stores from 500 to 1000 in this year. And by next year end, they will do 2000 stores also. All of this while increasing the GOV. Because like I told you, jo GOV Delhi mein hai, even today cities like Bangalore and, you know, Bombay and Hyderabad do not have it, and right now also they are still present only in 8 cities. Can you imagine? We have the entire of India to cover. Like, just imagine the freaking scope that Blinkit has. And the last thing is unka, like I told you, were going out. I think they recently they are in talks with that payment, you know, they acquired their business. They want to be a one-stop shop for all the B2C. So next time aap Zomato mein jao, aap Blinkit se bhi order kar sakte ho, food delivery kar sakte ho. Varna aapko like movie ka ticket book karna ho, kuch bhi live concert ka book karna ho, this also you will be able to do. So the next phase they're also targeting is this going out ka segment, you know, that is where the most focus is on. Okay, like absolutely stunning set of numbers. Like I told you, nothing to complain over here. I know a lot of you all will complain about this valuation and everything, but here is the thing. My stance on Zomato ka valuation remains the same as I did, you know, when it turned profitable in Q1. It turned profitable, right? 2 crore ka profit kiya tha. It is the same stance. I think, like, first of all, like in terms of valuation, like I tell Zomato, what will you compare Zomato with? Like, if I have to do a wire and cable ka company and Polycap ka main compare karu, I have other players, right? I have KEI, I have Delton, Dynamic, Paramount, and all of these universal cables. What will I compare Zomato with? Like, what is the metric? That is number one. The second thing is, on one side, I think these are the new age tech businesses. Going forward, aapka kya Asian Paints, kya all of these Zomato and everything only will change your lives, right? At the end of the day, think about this. Pehle, nobody even could fathom that we would be ordering something, you know, so frequently. Now think about this. Whenever you feel lazy, all you can think is Zomato, and it's just something that's there subconsciously in you. Like it's just happens. It's an involuntary reaction these days we have, right? Not just in terms of Zomato, even in terms of Blinkit. Like, I don't think it's very rare that these days, you know, we see people going to grocery stores and buying. Like, you know, even there we can see the trend change. Anything you need, Blinkit. Anything you need, Swiggy, Instamart, Kardo, right? That is what we see, a common trend. And earlier you will see, it used to be only for fruits and vegetables. Now Blinkit is having 25,000 SKUs, plus SKUs, right? Going forward, who knows, you will be able to buy laptop and everything also. Already they've started with this electronic things, you know, boat car and everything. Who knows, going forward you will be able to do that also, right? I mean, already we are seeing shift. Like, I can see it in myself, ki like, you know, I don't go, before I used to like, you know, you want something, you would see in Amazon. Now you would go and see in Blinkit, and you know, Blinkit mein hai ke ya nahi, right? Like that's bonkers, that's crazy. So on one side you have nothing to compare Zomato with. The second thing is if you look at Zomato is, I'm not finding the right word actually. Like, you have nothing to compare it with. Although the valuations are really high, how do you deny the possible scope that is happening over here? How do you deny the fact that we are having a behavioral shift, right? And that is undeniable over here, right? So I believe that is why you can't really compare Zomato with anything, and you just can't keep talking about valuation and one thing and ignore what this has been doing. I completely agree, the criticism that Zomato got while it was listed is absolutely right, because it was was a loss-making company and they got listed, you know, at quite absurd valuation, leaving nothing for retail investors. But right now, when it is turning profitable and the profits are literally soaring and they're getting up new SKUs, like, think about it, right? If it were any other normal business, right? Aap ek retail ka ek, let's say apparel ka business karo, theek hai? Wo jaake bol rahe ki, like, main store double karunga, mera ASP badhne wala hai, mera value growth hone wala hai, right? Like, mera demand acha hai aur mera ye vertical mein ye naya karunga, main premiumization karunga, ye karunga. सब लोग तो वहाँ पे कूद के जाएंगे. सी, दिस इज नॉट अ बाय और सेल रिकमेंडेशन. दैट टाइम वुड यू क्रिटिसाइज दैट अपैरल बिजनेस? तुम आप लोगों को तो बोलेंगे लाइक अरे ये क्या नहीं. सो आई डो नॉट अंडरस्टैंड वाई पीपल डोंट डू द सेम थिंग फॉर जोमैटो. लाइक यू नो इट्स लिटरली डूइंग एवरीथिंग. आप अपना इन्वेस्टमेंट फिलोसफी में अगर आप देखते हो, वॉल्यूम ग्रोथ हो, वैल्यू ग्रोथ हो, इट इज लिटरली डूइंग एवरीथिंग. द ओनली ओनली ऑफकोर्स द ओनली थिंग इज के लाइक वैल्यूएशन इसका हाई. आई थिंक फॉर दैट रीजन यू कांट लिटरली लाइक ignore the good things it has been doing, right? So again, that's that about Zomato. The last thing hum discussed, oh my god, already 25 minutes ho gaya. This is going to be a very long video. I didn't expect it. Theek hai, the last is going to be PNGS Gargi. Theek hai, PNGS Gargi again, वेरी गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स. अगर आप देखते हो उनका जो रेवेन्यू है, रेवेन्यू ग्रो बाय यू नो रेवेन्यू डबल हुआ है. इनफैक्ट लास्ट टाइम 6.5 करोर्स का, अभी 13.6 करोर है. ठीक है, आई थिंक 95% का रेवेन्यू ग्रोथ है. एंड उनका पैट जो है, पैट हैज गोन फ्रॉम 1.5 करोर्स टू 2.9 करोर्स बोथ ईयर ऑन ईयर. सो अराउंड 95% का रेवेन्यू ग्रोथ एंड 92% का पैट ग्रोथ, आई थिंक इन दैट रेंज द नंबर्स कम. ठीक है, नाउ डोंट डू द मिस्टेक दैट आई डिड व्हेन यू आर लुकिंग फॉर पीएनजीएस गर्गी का रिजल्ट. सो मैंने क्या किया, जब मैंने रिजल्ट डॉक्यूमेंट खोला तो आई सॉ that bhai revenue has gone up 5.6x aur pat jo hai has gone from 1 crore to 10 crore matlab 10x pat hua hai matlab ye kya kar rahe hai matlab itna operating leverage you know that's how I saw and then I just went down and I saw the next page in the result document and I was like oh shit no a bit disappointed. So kya hua hai yahan pe gargi mein, as you all know PNGS Gargi jo hai aur PNGS Gadkil and Sons jo hai, both of them have the same promoter, parent company same hai. Theek hai, matlab aap agar PNGS Gargi ka dekhte it is selling artificial jewelry and jo traditional PNGS Gargi, again I've covered this also in the business analysis playlist, watch that to get more clarity. The parent company same and inka jo artificial jewelry ka store unka parent company mein bhi shop in shop mein tha. Theek hai, now what they have done is they've converted this parent store mein jo shop in shop tha, it used to be FOCO, that is franchise operated and company owned, company owned tha, and now they've changed from that model to franchise owned and franchise operated. Because of this there is a one time sale, iske liye you're seeing that huge in terms of revenue growth and PAT growth, but ultimately jo aap end customer ke liye sale karte ho, apne jewelry bechte ho, that has been you know hardly 95, not hardly of course it's a lot, 95% in terms of revenue growth and I think 92% in terms of PAT growth. So good set of numbers only, of course for them everything is playing well because unka store expansion sahi se ho raha hai. Unka bahut badhiya game tha was introducing that 18 carat ka wo jo gold with the diamond ka tha, because of which you saw that volume growth bhi aane laga, but the most important thing was value growth, because आप PNGS Gargi का normal chain जो देखते हो, earrings जो देखते हो, उसका ASP था from I think 400, 500 to maximum was 1200. With this the ASP would go from 15,000 even max to max 25,000, 50,000 also. So as a result we saw all of the three parameters of ROE improve over here. ठीक है, the only thing with Gargi is I think they won't be able to achieve this 100 crores in revenue that they told कि like you know उनका target था they will do 100 crores in revenue. Again I do understand this is something they told pre-IPO, not and after IPO they told like no, that is something we mentioned in interview, don't take that seriously, we will do how much ever we can abhi. So I think with respect to that agar aap dekhte ho thoda sa, because 13.6 crore karte ho is Q1 mein, तो आगे जाके Q3 और Q4 में थोड़ा ज्यादा ही प्रेशर आएगा, बट ऑल इन ऑल गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स. अगेन नथिंग टू कंप्लेन. आई डोंट थिंक वी ऑल्सो हैव टू टेक दैट 100 करोड़ इनटू कंसिडरेशन व्हेन द मैनेजमेंट हैज रिपीटेडली टोल्ड इन लास्ट टू कॉन कॉल्स के लाइक यू नो दैट इज समथिंग वी टोल्ड इन इंटरव्यू, डोंट टेक इट सीरियसली. सो बट ओवरऑल गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स, बिकॉज ग्रोइंग योर सेल्स आर 95% इज नो जोक, राइट? एंड इन टर्म्स वाइल यू आर एक्सपैंडिंग, मेंटेनिंग योर मार्जिन्स एंड बीइंग प्रॉफिटेबल, इट इज एक्चुअली वेरी कमेंडेबल. सो गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स. जैसे मैंने बोला सारा का सारा बिजनेसेस जो है बहुत अच्छा है. द ओनली थिंग आई विल टेल इज टिना रबर और गर्गी जो है इस वैल्यूएशंस में जो है इट हैज टू कीप परफॉर्मिंग इन ऑर्डर टू सस्टेन द करंट वैल्यूएशन दैट इज सेट. लाइक इट एवरी क्वार्टर जब ये इसका रिजल्ट आता है इट हैज टू परफॉर्म, वर द वरना मार्केट उसको नहीं छोड़ेगा, राइट? दैट इज वॉट इट इज राइट नाउ. इट इज लाइक राइडिंग द टाइगर. दैट इज द बेस्ट वे टू पुट इट. एज लॉन्ग एज ग्रोथ इज देयर, मार्केट विल कीप रिवॉर्डिंग दीज बिजनेसेस. द मिनट द ग्रोथ फॉल्टर्स, द सेम मार्केट विल कम एंड यू नो इट विल स्टार्ट हिटिंग देम, यू नो. दैट इज दैट. अगेन एंडिंग दिस वीडियो बाय टेलिंग जस्ट गुड सेट ऑफ नंबर्स, ग्रेट एग्जीक्यूशन, वेरी ब्रिलियंट मैनेजमेंट ऑल ऑफ द कंपनीज. Real, let's look forward for Q2 and see if all of these things sustains or not. Okay? And that's that. See ya tomorrow. Bye.